retirement incomes, Tony. We're getting to the stage of another round of reforms, do you think?
I think we are, because we not only have the Royal Commission, which is sort of more the structural product offering areas, we also have the product and advice and so on. We also have the Productivity Commission, which also had those elements in it. But the government has yet to formally respond to the Productivity Commission. So we may see some formal announcements from the government in relation to that.
Do you have any understanding of when that timing might be?
No, they haven't actually said, but we would hope it would be sooner rather than later. And the ALP have been very quiet on that. So both the ALP and the Coalition have said that they would implement the default fund model as suggested by Hayne.
Yep.
And also, so you know, the question is, you know, how all that fits together in relation to the default fund model designed by the Productivity Commission. So we're yet to see
how
all that works.
Yeah, and how, whether it sticks with the employee moving or whether it sticks with the workplace.
That's right.
Resolving the fund.
And does it fit, you know, how does it fit within the workplace model, you know, so on and so forth. A lot of those things end up being an employee capital type argument, depending on which side of the fence you tend to sit. So we'll have to see how all that plays out. But what we would like to see is that we think the annual contribution caps need to be scrapped, and we would like a lifetime limit. So exactly the same way as small business has a lifetime cap, for exactly, you know, the small business saves in its business, hopefully sells it for a tidy sum of money, and then has a rollover, in some cases, an ability to. We would like that model to apply to everyone. Because we think the current system quite, you know, with appropriate transitional measures, we don't think the current annual contribution cap system works, especially with the 25 grand a year. We think there needs to be greater flexibility.
And with the, in the advice space, with the super reforms that came in 2016, with the changes to non-concessional caps and concessional caps, and it's really actually hard to continually keep track of them all. It's yet another administrative cost, really, in providing advice, because the penalties for contributing above caps are quite significant. You can do it almost accidentally.
You can do it accidentally. So there's a number of reforms we would like to see there. So we would also like to see the government have said, okay, we will allow CGT concessions on super fund mergers until 2020. So that is a sunset clause on that date. The Productivity Commission has said, okay, let's make it open-ended. We actually agree with that, so we've been advocating for that for some time. And the other thing that we would really like to see is some further work done on elder abuse, enduring powers of attorney, binding nominations, so on and so forth. That's a very big issue that the government knows it needs to deal with, because the Law Reform Commission has said, okay, you've got to look into this. But as yet, the state governments, the territory governments, the federal government, have yet to come together or bring you know, individuals together to talk about this, about how it may work.
Mm. Lots of fingers in those pies, aren't there?
Indeed, lots of fingers. Mm. And last but not least, we need some further work done on actuarial certificates for self-managed super funds. We need some simplification there. At the moment, the system's a bit of a mess. So we would like the government to agree to make a very small but important administrative change to the tax law.
No, thanks, Tony. Hopefully we'll see some good superannuation initiatives in the federal budget lockup.
Well, hopefully.
The key word being good.
Yes.